Okay, today we're going to be looking at threads, and there's two ways you could create threads. One way, the first way I'm going to show you here, is to extend a class thread. So as we can see here, public class myThreads extends thread. Once you extend thread, you have to override run. Run is a method in thread, and it doesn't have anything in it, so you need to override it and put something in it. So in my case, I put a print statement that says thread is running. And in my class, I made some other methods, method A that just prints out method A, and method B that just prints out method B. The second way you could create a thread is to implement runnable. And just like extends thread, you should override the run method and put something in there. In this case, I put a print statement for the run method. Now, the two different ways of running threads, I have created a class that will take both of them and implement them in two different ways. The first way, which was from the thread, when I extend the thread, I created a myThread T, gets new myThreads, and I started the thread by typing t.start, and then t.methodB, t.run, and t.methodA. Once you start a thread, you cannot start it again. It will give you an error in runtime. So it needs to be run to completion before it could ever be started again. Now, there is a lot of debate about threads because threads don't always run the way you want it to run. Threads kind of run their own little pattern, and even though I set to do method B and then access the run method again and then do method A, once a thread is running, it may stop in the middle of what it's doing and try to complete run and try to complete method B before completing the start, which is very interesting. And the only way you could control that is by synchronizing the methods, which you should be looking up in your chapter about synchronizing methods. We won't go into full detail about synchronizing methods, but on the final exam, you might need to know that in order to control threads, you have to synchronize a method. And that's just a hint right there for the final exam. Also, the second one, we could see right here, the class was named runnable, so I created a runnable R, new runnable. And then I created a generic thread by just calling the regular class thread T2. And it gets new thread, and you notice I pass in as a parameter right here the runnable R. Then I start it down here. That's the two differences here. From here, you could just start the thread by just creating a by when you extended a class, have it just start. Where here is that you have to create a thread by passing your runnable. Okay, we'll go ahead and run that and see what happens. Okay, you notice that when I ran this, method B ran first. Let's take a look. I hit start, which should run this first, theoretically. But it decided when it ran to go to the second one. Once it started, it decided to do method B first and print out method B. Then it did the run statement, which was thread is running than it did method A. It printed out end, which was right here. And then it decided to do the run method, thread is running, before it completed. So as you could see, even though we had this stacked in order here of a way we wanted it to run, it did not run in that complete order. It ran out of order because the thread kind of automatically chooses what to run once it's started. And it changes per machine. The Valencia machines will run this completely different than my machine here at home, and my laptop will run it completely different as well. So it all depends on which machinery you're running at the time. And like I said, the way to control this is to type the keyword synchronize and to control the threads that way, which I will actually show you another video on synchronization. I will post that tomorrow for you. But right now I just wanted to show you a generic way of running the threads. And down here, you'll notice that I show you the second way of running a thread. I did t.start. I didn't have any other methods to run, so it just ran the run thread run, which was in the print statement here in run. I will go ahead and also post the code for this on your web CT, so you could play around with it once you look at synchronization and so on. There's also the second video I'll post tomorrow will also show you join and sleep and wait, the other methods that are in when using threads, to give you a better example of that. This was just a general overview of what threads do. Okay, I hope this helps, and remember to look at the PowerPoint presentation on threads that I'll also post on this, and I will also post a review for the final exam. A more generic one will be posted today, and tomorrow will be posted a little bit more in depth detail about the final exam. The final exam will be curved just like your midterm. However, I do the curve for the final exam a little bit different, in part that I do a more of a generic curve than the whole class average thing that I did for the midterm. Not to worry, because everyone right now is looking in great shape, and the final exam, once it's curved, your grade will probably remain the same what you are right now. So remember also to email me if you cannot make the final exam schedule, and I will post another video tomorrow. So good luck.